Let's compare Windows 11 23H2 to Windows 11 22H2. On the left we have Windows 11 22H2 build 22621, which was released on the 20th of September 2022. And on the right we have Windows 11 23H2 build 22631, which was released on the 31st of October 2023. In 22H2 the search on the taskbar is just an icon, in 23H2 it is a search box and it has some art at the right. In an update to 22H2 the search button has the word search on it, but it is still just a button, it's not a text box like it is in 23H2. In 22H2 when you right-click the taskbar you only get taskbar settings, in 23H2 you also get task manager. But this was added to 22H2 in an update. In 23H2 there is an option to show seconds on the taskbar clock, in 22H2 there is not. In Windows 11 23H2 there is an option to show a separate taskbar button for each instance and show labels like in Windows 95, NT 4.0, 98, 2000, Mi, XP, and Vista, and is available in Windows 7, 8, 8.1 and Windows 10. In Windows 11 22H2 there is not. Let's compare the widgets dashboard. In 23H2 it is wider and has more columns than it does in 22H2. In 22H2 it has a clock at the top which it doesn't in 23H2. In 23H2 it has a full screen button which it doesn't in 22H2. In 22H2 there is a chat icon on the taskbar, in 23H2 there is not. In 23H2, Settings now has a home page. In 23H2, Settings now has a section to control RGB lighting. In 22H2 it does not. In 23H2 there is a Copilot, Preview, which is an AI chatbot assistant, which can also analyze images. Let's compare the File Explorer. In 22H2 this PC contains both folders and drives, in 23H2 it only contains drives. In 23H2 File Explorer now has tabs, however this was added to 22H2 via an update. In 22H2 the actions are directly below the title bar, and the address bar is below the actions. In 23H2 the address bar is directly below the title bar, and the actions bar is below the address bar. In 23H2 there is a button at the right of the actions bar to bring up the details pane, in 22H2 to get the details pane you have to go to view and then show. In 23H2 there is now a gallery view which shows all your pictures. Windows 11 23H2 now has native support for RAR archives, which 22H2 does not. In 23H2 Task Manager now has a search bar at the top where you can search for a running process. In 22H2 it does not. Let's compare Paint. In 22H2 the page is top left aligned, in 23H2 it is centered. In 23H2, Cut, Copy, and Paste are now under an Edit menu rather than the Clipboard group. In 23H2 Paint now supports layers, which in 22H2 it does not. In 23H2 Paint now supports transparency, in 22H2 Paint just interprets transparency as white. When you save the image as a PNG, the layers are flattened, but the transparency is retained. If you save as a bitmap, the transparency gets converted to white. If you save as a GIF, the transparency also gets converted to white, even though GIF does support binary transparency. In 23H2, Paint now has the option to remove backgrounds from images, in 22H2 it does not. In 23H2, Notepad now has tabs, so you can have multiple documents open in the same window. In 22H2, Notepad does not have tabs. In 23H2, Notepad can also remember the last session next time it is opened. In 22H2, snipping tool can only take screenshots. In 23H2, it can also record video. In 23H2, snipping tool can now extract text from screenshots. And you can also open an image with snipping tool and have it extract text from that image. In 23H2, the Photos app can now blur the background of images. It will automatically detect which part it thinks is the background, using AI. You can also use the selection brush tool to select and deselect areas. Windows 11 23H2 now comes with Outlook, which Windows 11 22H2 does not. In 23H2 there is now a Windows backup app, in 22H2 there is not. In Windows 11 23H2 under Sound Output, there is a volume mixer where you can adjust the volume individually for each app. In 22H2 there is not.
An outline and the window only moves when you let go. They both have the modern start menu, and the classic start menu is still an option in both. In Windows XP when you click Control Panel on the start menu it comes up in a window. In Windows Server 2003 it comes up in a list. In Windows Server 2003 there are more administrative tools than there are in Windows XP.